Hi, my name is Antonin. I'm very pleased to be here, and I will present a joint work with François Durand from Nokia Labs and Mathias Nunez, who is also at CNRS. So we are interested generally in the following question: how do preferences map to voting outcome when voters are strategic? And we know that game theory is not always very useful to answer to this question because there are too many equilibria. So a useful tool is the game theoretic setting introduced by Meyerson, in which you have population uncertainty, so you have some noise, and with that, this reduces the equilibria that you have. So the model is as follows. The electorate is drawn from a Poisson distribution. The voters will condition their strategic behavior, their votes on pivot events, which are basically ties among candidates. And the best replies will depend on the relative likelihood of these events. So this is a model, and we are interested in particular on the rule of approval voting. So approval voting is a prominent alternative to plurality voting or first past the post, which is often used in the US, in the UK. And this is a voting rule in which voters may approve as many candidates as they want, and the candidate with most approvals is elected. This is usually sought in the literature to promote voter coordination and to foster sincerity among voters. And in practice, it is not used a lot, but it is used, for instance, in the city of Fargo since the midterms, and it has been employed recently in the votes on the Brexit motion by the UK Parliament. Okay, so the main tool for our analysis will be this following mathematical object, which will be a pivotal event. What we call a pivotal event between two candidates A and B is a very specific event in which the score of A is equal to the score of B, and these scores are higher than the score of all the other candidates. So this is a very rare event, but this is the only event in which the vote of the voters will matter. So they will condition their votes on this type of events, and if this is the most likely pivotal event, a voter will vote for A if he prefers A to B, and B if he prefers B to A. So that's the basic idea. So what do we know about plurality voting? In plurality voting, we know well how it works. It is pretty simple. The equilibria that we have are equilibria in which only two candidates receive vote at equilibrium. And this is known since the 50s. The idea is as follows. If you assume that the pivotal events where A and B are tied at the top is much more likely than all the other pivotal events, then all the voters want either to vote for A if they prefer A to B, or to B if they prefer B to A. And as a result, we have a self-fulfilling prophecy. Given their behavior, it becomes true that the probability of this event is much more likely than the probability of the other pivotal events. That's the idea. And as a result, any race between any pairs of candidates can be focal, and the outcome of the election may be annihilated from the preferences. In particular, if there exists a Condorcet winner, it might not be elected by plurality rule. Okay, so can we do better? So can we do something better with approval voting? So that's the question we ask. So there are a couple of difficulties with approval voting. The first thing is that multiple candidates can be approved, so the choice, the behavior of the voter is more complicated, and the best reply will depend not only on the main pivot, but all the orderings of all the pivot events. And the second difficulty, if you look at the definition of a pivot, is that because a single voter can approve several candidates, the scores of the candidates will be correlated. So computing the probability of a pivot will be more complicated in that case. Because of this complication, we'll focus on the case where we have three candidates, but we'll do that for general preferences. So to start and to introduce my work, let's consider a voter with the following preferences. He prefers A to B to C. What's her strategy with approval voting? So a first observation that is very simple is that you will always approve A and you will never approve C. So the main question is whether you approve B or you do not approve B. And the answer is that it depends. If the pivot event between A and B is very likely, so most probably you will decide between A and B, then since you prefer A to B, you will not approve B. So you vote only A. if the main pivotal event is between B and C, most likely you will decide between B and C. So you prefer to approve B. And yes, you will approve B. So that's you will vote AB, meaning that you approve both A and B. And there's a last possibility that those two pivots are of a similar magnitude. In that case, the best reply will be more complicated. It will depend both on the relative likelihood of those two events and on the cardinal utilities of the voter. Okay, so I will represent the game that I will be considering by the following graphical representation. What do I have in this graphical representation? I have in green the six types of voters that may exist. So a type of a voter is a cardinal ordering. So A, B, C prefers A to B to C. And for each type, I have two possibilities. Either I vote for A or I vote for AB. Okay, so I can represent all the types and all their strategies on this single graphical representation. Before introducing the model, I will start with an example. So let's consider this example. This is a profile. I have 40% of voters here, 15% of the voters here, and 45% of the voters here. What are the equilibria in this example? There are two kinds of equilibria. There will be one first equilibrium for which we will have this ordering of the pivots. Here, because the main pivot will be between A and B, nobody wants to play AB or to play C. So this will completely determine the behavior of the voter. So they will vote for A, they will vote for B, and they will vote for BC. When we look at the score, they are like that. And what do we obtain for this particular equilibrium? First, we have a good news. That is that the Condorcet winner, which is B in this example, will be elected. But there are strange things happening that in this example, B and C, they have the highest score, but the main pivot, the pivot that dominates, will not be the pivot between B and C. And that is related to the correlation between the score of the voter, because every time C gets an approval, B also gets an approval. Okay, so there are some complicated things happening here. And I have a second equilibrium in this particular example that has different features. It is as follows. So the main pivot is AC, and the other pivots are comparable magnitude. And the strategies and the score are as follows. So what do we have in this example? A first remark is that this is an example in which the elected candidate is not the Condorcet winner, so we don't always have Condorcet consistency. And the second remark is that this equilibrium will be particular because the strategies of these two types will depend on their cardinal utilities. And this is related to the fact that those two events are of a similar magnitude. So let me start by introduce the formal model. So I have three candidates, A, B, C, and we are in a Poisson games. So the number N of voters is drawn from a Poisson distribution of mean N. There are six possible types of voters. A, B, C is the type of voter who prefers A to B to C. And each type T has utility zero for the last choice, one for the first choice, and we assume that they have a utility UT for the second choice. So UT is the utility that these types attach to B. Okay? So the voters are drawn from the Poisson distribution, and each voter has a type that will be drawn independently from the other voter from a distribution on the set of types. So this is R. So here, R is the profile of ordinal preferences, and U gives the cardinal representation of these preferences. The strategies of the voters are to choose a message in this set, so either to approve only one candidate or to approve two candidates, and a strategy profile assigns to each type one message. So here, what do we have? For any profile, we'll have the expected share of a ballot M, which will be the sum over all types that vote for M of the share of these types. So this is an expected share, and the number of ballot M will be a Poisson distribution of mean N to M. And the crucial thing here that is shown by Meyerson is that these variables are independent. By contrast, when I look at the scores will also have a Poisson distribution, but this Poisson distribution will be correlated. Okay, so then we can define very mechanically the utility at a given outcome. And for a given profile, we have, from this, we know that they are drawn from Poisson distribution that are independent. So we have some probability distribution on the outcome. And we can define the expected utility. And from the expected utility, we can define the best reply for a type, which is just to choose the message that maximizes the expected utility. Okay. So what do we have in this model? So from a given strategy profile, we can define the Ballot profile. With the Poisson probability model, the Ballot profile defines beliefs over the event that may happen. And from the beliefs, we may define the best reply of the voter. Okay, so from this graph, we will be able to define an equilibrium notion. So my definition of an equilibrium is specific. I'll require the equilibria to be quite stable in the following sense. Sigma is a stable equilibrium if each sigma t is the best reply both for large n, and also I will require that it is the best reply not only for the tau that is associated to the sigma, but for any tau prime that is arbitrarily close to tau, which means that what we require is that the equilibria are stable and they are robust to a small dose of what we call aggregate uncertainty in this setting. So this is just a stable notion. So I will first analyze these equilibria. And to analyze this equilibria, I will just analyze first this arrow of best reply and then this arrow of beliefs. So on the best replies, I have a formal result that is very simple and that corresponds to the previous intuition that I gave. The best reply of a type ABC is either to vote for A or to vote for AB. And this depends on a particular parameter delta, which depends on the probabilities of the pivot events. So for instance, if this event is much more likely than the other event, as this is positive, I will want to, so delta will be positive and I will want to vote for A. Okay, so now if we want to determine the best reply of the voter, what we need to be able to do is to compare the relative likelihood of the pivot event. So this is what we will do next. This is the analysis of the beliefs of the voter. And here we need to introduce another concept, which is the magnitude of the event. We know that the events are really rare, and the magnitude of an event will measure the rate at which the probability of the event converges to zero. So the event that we have the following expression. The probability is an exponential, and the magnitude mu of e is the parameter in front of the n. Okay, so the main property of the magnitude is that events with a higher magnitude are infinitely more likely than the other events. That's very useful to describe and to compare the relative likelihood of the different pivotal events in our game. And what do we have? We have a characterization of the events that are important for us, a characterization of the pivotal events. They can be either equal to the magnitude of an equality between two candidates or to the magnitude of an equality between three candidates. And so this is a technical lemma, but it is crucial to obtain the following characterization of the equilibria. So what do we obtain? We obtain that we have, in fact, two types of equilibria. We have some direct equilibria for which the magnitude of the three pivot events that matter for us are strictly ordered, and equilibria in which two magnitudes are equal. So this is just a characterization of all the equilibria that we may have in that games, and we can just do some remarks on these equilibria. The first remark is that in the second type of equilibria, the cardinal utilities of the voter will matter. And this runs contrary to most works in this area, that cardinal utilities may matter when we compare extremely rare events. And the second remark is that this is mostly a technical remark. So if some of you know the works of Meyerson-Weber, in models previous to the Poisson model, there were some Bailiff restrictions that were used in order to avoid the computation of probabilities. These Bailiff restrictions were telling that pivots with popular candidates must be much more likely than the other pivots. And we have a striking result that these Bailiff restrictions, they never hold in this Poisson model where we can compute the probabilities. This restriction never hold at a stable equilibrium. So there's a strong discrepancy between the previous model and the Poisson model with approval voting. Okay, so these are the technical things that we can say about the equilibria. So we have some direct equilibria in which the magnitudes are ordered, and from this order we can derive the best reply, and some indirect equilibria where some best reply are derived from this ordering, and some best reply depend on the utilities. And finally, we are interested in the Condorcet consistency. We want to know whether with approval voting we'll be able to elect the Condorcet winner or not. So the first thing that we have is that we don't have a full existence of stable equilibria, but we have some conditional existence. For every ordinal profile, we have some cardinal representation for which a stable equilibrium exists. And moreover, in this equilibrium, the Condorcet winner will be elected if this is a profile for which we have a Condorcet winner. So we have a conditional Condorcet consistency. To know more about the Condorcet consistency of the equilibria in general, we perform some Monte Carlo simulation where we take a uniform distribution for the ordinal profile and for the cardinal utilities. So I will finish my presentation by showing the following picture. So what do I have here? I have here the universe of all possible ordinal profiles over the set of three candidates. And here, I have the probability that corresponds to the draws of cardinal utilities. So I draw two lines. In the blue line, there is the probabilities of having a stable equilibrium that elects a Condorcet winner. So this is sometimes equal to one. Sometimes it is below one, but it is always significant. And in orange, I have the probability of having an equilibrium that does not elect a Condorcet winner. So we see that with approval voting, it is much more likely to have an equilibrium that elects a Condorcet winner than the contrary. And just as a background, under plurality voting, we always have one equilibrium that elects the Condorcet winner. So the blue line is here. And we always have an equilibrium that does not elect the Condorcet winner. So in that sense, with approval voting, we are much more likely to go towards the direction of electing a Condorcet winner. So just to finish, we have a comprehensive description of the equilibria. Contrary to plurality voting, we have shown that things are a bit more complicated because cardinal utilities matter. And finally, we have some Condorcet consistency of the rule, but with some caveats. First, we have a stable equilibrium where the Condorcet winner is elected, but only for some cardinal utilities. And second, we have sometimes some stable equilibrium that do not elect the Condorcet winner, but these equilibria are quite unlikely. And thank you for your attention. Yes. Yeah, that's what we assume for now. Yeah. Not in general. So what I can say is that whenever we have a direct equilibrium, so the best reply do not depend at all on the utilities. So the equilibrium that you will get under our assumption will be also equilibria under your assumption. So this will not change. And yes, and then things will start to change for indirect equilibria. I would guess that things will be very similar. So this is just to simplify the analysis that we have made this assumption, but I don't think it's very... So here, the strategies are with a threshold. So if everything is closed and you are far from the threshold, everything will be the same.